Handrails are a huge part of skateboarding history. It's always been such a big testing ground. You know, you don't really have a trick mastered until you've done it on a rail, or a trick itself isn't even legitimate until someone's taken it to a rail. It's been such a huge part of skateboarding for the last few decades, but where has handrail skateboarding come from? Is it possible that it wasn't Gonz? Let's take a look. Welcome back to Radarite Video, the channel where you can learn new things about skateboarding. I do a lot of different stuff on this channel, from teaching tricks to talking about skateboarding culture and history, answering your questions on Ask Radarite, and all kinds of different stuff. Subscribe so you can keep up with all of that. Today, I wanted to talk about handrails, which have been a huge part of skateboarding culture for 20 to 30 years, especially in the 90s, though. It was a big deal. Transworld had a policy where they only wanted to publish photos of handrails and grass, was what they would say. But taking new tricks to rails, doing longer rails, people's whole skateboarding careers were focused on nothing but handrails, and so it was a big, big deal. But where did it come from first? Who was really the first person to slide on a handrail? We're going to talk about that today. I want to give a huge shout out and thanks to Dan McFarland, friend of the show, who did most of the research for this video and just handed it off to me. A lot of people have been asking about this topic, and I didn't have a ton of info. I didn't have a lot of in-depth stuff. He came through and just gave me all this stuff, which was a huge help. So thanks to him, and let's get right into it. The story that most people know dates back to sometime in the 80s at the Oceanside Amphitheater. There's a stage there with a five set, and Natas Kalpis very famously attempted a board slide on it. He didn't land it, he didn't even come close to landing it, but it was a brand new idea for a lot of people who saw it.
We hadn't heard about this. We had never seen this. We had no idea that anyone even thought like this. We all just stopped dead in our tracks and went, oh my God.
So here's this brand new concept in skateboarding that no one had ever attempted before. But when exactly did that happen? When was that contest that Natas did that in front of all those people? When was that? So I found an interview, well, Dan did specifically, but he found an interview with Gonz at the Emerge conference in 2016. It's with Dune, and he's talking about how he thought it was around 1984, Dune did anyway, and Gonz says he doesn't follow years, and he doesn't keep track of it. He doesn't know exactly when it happened. And 84 seems a little bit early. I found a Transworld article where they said straight out that it was in 1986, and that seems a little bit more likely because the contest where Natas tried it was on video, and contests weren't really filmed until 85 at the earliest. I don't know of any before that. So 86 does seem a little bit more likely, and since Transworld directly said it, I'm going to go with that. But so that was when he attempted it in front of people. But the story goes that a little bit after that, Gonz and Natas went out to try it. Natas was telling him how he had been attempting it down a rail at the beach where it landed into the sand. So he couldn't obviously roll away from it, but he had been trying to get up onto it and slide it, and he hadn't actually landed it yet. But they talked about it, and so Natas, Gonz, and Rocco went to a demo, and it was in Westwood, California. It was a small little demo, and Gonz and Natas both did a handrail for the first time in the same session right there. And so that's the story. It happened all in 1986, but did they actually do it first? Was that the very first one ever done? Well, back in that the Emerge conference thing I was telling you about, Gonz is very reluctant to take credit for doing it first.
So you and Natas are credited with the first handrail together,
yeah,
same session?
Well, I mean, I'm this Street Scott, but you know.
So Gonz mentions this guy called Street Scott, and I never heard of him before. I didn't know anything about him, so I thought I would look him up. And he did make it into Thrasher a few times in the early 80s. He is on the cover in 1982 doing an acid drop off of this little drop here. And he was in an article in April 1984. And there's not a ton of info about him. He was a steel worker who moved to California because he liked the skyline more and he wanted to skate more and stuff like that. One thing it does say about him, he's one of the more visible skaters on the San Francisco skate scene. So if you were around in the scene back then, you might have known who he was, but there's not a ton of coverage that still survives to now. So there was that stuff, and there was also this picture. This is from Thrasher in April 1985. Street Scott is doing a board slide down an 8 or 9 set in the Something Else feature. And we have very little more information about this. The caption basically just says that skateboarding is dangerous, and it says that he's sliding a shortcut down the stairs in Golden Gate Park. So that's really all we know about this trick. We don't know whether he landed it. We don't know if he cavemanned into it and he rolled away. We don't know whether he set his board up on the rail, kind of stepped on it, took a picture and stepped off real quick. We have no more information about it than that. And unfortunately, Street Scott has passed away, according to Gonz. He mentions that we'd have to dig him up. So we don't have any more information about the actual trick. It's possible that he landed it. It's possible he'd been doing it for years and just no one knew about it. But that's all we know. But one thing we do know for sure is that Gonz said that he was inspired by seeing that. And so whether he landed it or not, he was at least part of the puzzle that caused it to happen a little bit later when Gonz did it.
I saw that Street Scott thing and I didn't know if he did it or what, you know?
So in 1986, Natas and Gonz both landed their first handrail, but they were not the first to get it published. That goes to Johnny Kopp, assuming that Street Scott's was not a real land. This ad was published in Thrasher in June 1986. And keep in mind, this was published in the June issue. So if the issue hit the streets before that, the picture was taken before that, then the timeline here is really, really tight. And it's weird, like no one argues that Johnny was the first to actually land one, but it is really, really tight. So this was a quote from Transworld about this. Although Natas and Gonz had already been hitting handrails at contests and out in the streets for some time, Hawaiian power bra Johnny Kopp was the first to feature this new concept in the pages of Transworld via this caveman town and country ad, February 1987. It's kind of funny, they used the date that they first published it in Transworld, ignoring the fact that Thrasher published it 8 months before, which is kind of interesting. But still, no one argues that Johnny was the first, but he still deserves a lot of credit. You know, whether this was the first actual landed one that was photographed, whether he was just one of the earliest guys to do it, we don't know 100% for sure, but he does deserve quite a bit of props for doing that. I also wanted to shout out Julian Stranger, who did a board slide down some steps in 1986. Wasn't exactly on a handrail, but it's still in the ballpark. It's still the same concept that he's starting to push. But the first picture I know of Gonz doing one is in June 1987, and here it is. This is what the caption says. Usually untouchable in the area of obstacle skating, Mark Gonzalez racks up an ollie to a board slide on a 4-foot-high handrail. It's kind of funny how technical they have to describe that, because this is still a very new concept. People see someone on a handrail, they're not exactly sure what's going on. So it's kind of telling that they had to describe it like that. But around the same time, Julian Stranger did the first front board. Here's a picture of that. I don't have an exact date for this. The Chrome Ball incident says this is definitely the first. And I know Gonz did one in 88. So this might have been a couple months or maybe a year before. I'm not entirely sure. But that is pretty cool. But in 1988, that is when handrails really became a thing. You would start to see bigger and bigger rails. They started to step it up to the Federal Building and other bigger rails like that. Things are really starting to get legit. And not just the rails, but the actual trick started to expand a little bit more too. 1988 was the first ever published 50-50 grind on a handrail. This is Ed Templeton doing one. And it's kind of funny, this is the first published one, and they don't even give him credit. His name isn't on the ad at all. But that is definitely Ed doing it, which is pretty cool. He's not necessarily the first. Natas did one around the same time. Couldn't find a date for it, but he's doing it with copers on a rail, which is pretty impressive. And then Gonz had one as well that he did, but it wasn't published for a while. So the footage might be from before when Ed Templeton did it, but no one saw it for a few years. So Ed definitely gets some credit for being the first published 50-50 on a handrail. For certain, I was not the first to do a handrail. Gonz and Natas take that honor. Johnny Kopp did a board slide on a rail photo earlier too. It was just a zine in a time where things were happening, and it was very slow to be documented and shown in magazines. After hearing about Gonz and Natas doing them, wasn't there footage in some contest video of them sliding a rail? Loads of skater kids started trying them. Jason Lee, Mike V, Ray Barbie, and myself, along with lots of other local kids in HB, and I'm sure everywhere. I think he makes a really good point in that Instagram comment talking about how everyone was trying it at the time. As soon as they knew it was possible, kids all over the world who skated were trying to ollie up onto rails, and who knows what people did first. Exactly. Who's the first 5-0 grind? I don't know. Some kid in Nebraska who did it down a 3-set where his truck tapped it for a millisecond before he rode off the end. Like, we don't really know for sure. So that's why I'm careful in saying the first documented. That one you can prove, you can go through all the published things that came out at the time and pinpoint which one was first. But exactly who did everything first is kind of tough to say. But those are some of the big names. And being the first to be published doing something is a big deal because that pushes skateboarding forward. As soon as you see, wow, he's doing a grind on a rail, I thought you could only board slide those. Then that got the next guy inspired, which got the next guy inspired, which got Nigel Houston 5-0-ing 25 set, you know? So that's definitely really cool. But up until this point, handrails had still really not gotten to the modern level. They weren't doing really long stuff. They weren't doing that many different tricks. And so we also have to give a lot of credit to Frankie Hill and Pat Duffy. Frankie Hill, I have a whole video on him right here. Go into a lot more detail. Check that video out. There's a lot of really cool stuff that he did. But he was doing huge rails. He was doing like, he did a 30 set. He didn't land it, but the footage was in the video. People saw him attempted it. They knew that it was possible. And so that really helped push things into the bigger and bigger level. A couple years later, Pat Duffy was doing every trick. It wasn't just a board slide and a 50-50. He was doing Smiths. He was doing tail slides. He was doing all kinds of stuff like that. He was doing nose grinds, doing back lip, you know, in the rain even. So those guys really helped take a handrail from a concept to like a board slide being an ender to being just something you can do and really pushing it to the next level. And then we had all the guys in the 90s. I'm not going to try to list every NBD who was the first, you know, switch 50-50 and all that stuff. I don't really know all that kind of stuff. But those are the guys who really helped make handrails into a major part of street skating. So that's what I came up with for this. Again, thanks to Dan for filling in a lot of that information so this video could get made. But until next time, here are a lot more videos that I do on the channel. I do game reviews, I do all kinds of stuff. You can learn tricks on the channel. So check all that stuff out. Make sure you tap my logo on the screen right here to subscribe, and that way you can keep learning new things about skateboarding. Thanks for watching.